Hi Mirnaz, how are you?
Fine, how are you?
Thank you so much. It seems here is the air is polluted, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
So how we can measure this pollution?
So you can use electronic sensors to just measure it.
How is it possible?
So we have different type of MQ sensors. We have MQ series, like as MQ2, MQ3, MQ135, MQ9, MQ4.
The difference between these sensors, can you explain it to me?
The MQ2 actually is used for example, alcohol or methane. MQ135 is used for the air quality. You can use MQ9 for the carbon monoxide, MQ8 for the hydrogen gas, and many different type of MQ sensors for different for gases.
So, can you explain about the shape of these sensors?
Actually, this sensor is working same as other sensors. As you can see in this picture, it's working with the 5 volts and ground, and we have analog and digital pins. Analog is reading the environment signals and convert it to the analog with the op amp.
So how can I distinguish the difference between these sensors from the shape actually?
Actually, if you can see in this picture, there is like a ring around the stainless steel. On that ring, you can find the number of the module.
So, how can I, for example, work with these sensors like as the one practical project actually?
So, when you connect it, when you wire it, as I told you, you can also refer to this Arduino hardware and software to know where is the analog pins and digital pins and how to program it. But yeah, on the sensors you have the power LED and also you have the signal LED. Yeah, these are turned on when everything is working correctly. When the sensor is reading the numbers from the environment, it has an op amp on it and also the potentiometer. You can control the intensity with the potentiometer, and op amp will compare that signal with the number you adjusted, and it will give the command to the Arduino or the LED, whatever you have set it up, and it will work for you.
So can you explain about the accuracy of these sensors?
This sensor is really accurate, but just make sure when you are using in your project, just power it for 24 hours. It doesn't mean that just power it and set it over there. Just be in contact with the gas you are targeting for your project.
So I'm so interested. You show me this sensor, how does it work, and show me one practical project. Is it possible for you?
Yeah, exactly. But before that, I need to explain another thing for you, because it has a stainless steel on it. This cap, if you can see, it has a heating element inside of it. This heating element needs to be protected from the dust. And after that, we have this cap on, under it. And underneath, we have like a tin dioxide and other chemicals which are have a role to distinguish the gas for us.
So thank you so much. Let's go to the practical project and show me the lab.
Exactly. Just follow me. These are the MQ sensors. As you can see, this is MQ2. These are the pins. As you can see here, these are the pins. This is the VCC. This is the ground. This is digital and analog pins. This is the potentiometer, as I told you, the power LED and the signal LED. And this is the sensitive area, which is covered with this stainless steel. Then, these are the buzzer I will use. These are the LEDs, just one, and wires, this one, Arduino. open up the Arduino IDE, I'm going to write the code here. As I told you, we have analog and digital pins. You can refer to the Arduino software program, which we have prepared before for you, to see how to write the code for it. In the void setup, I'm going to write the pin, digital pin and analog pin. For example, pin A0, we are going to choose it for the analog pin A0. We set it as an input because we need to read the sensor for us. Then we have the pin mode number 8 as an output, because we have an LED. Then we have pin mode number 7, which is output again for the buzzer. Now I am going to introduce a serial begin, because I need to have the also a serial monitor to work. Then in the void loop, I'm going to write my code. I'm introducing the int a equal to analog read from pin A0, and then after that I'm telling that if, for example, A is bigger than 120, digital write, turn on the LED high, delay 500, then digital write 8 low, delay for 500. Then after that, I'm going to use the serial monitor. So serial that print, just print for us B ever of small. Then I'm going to write the code for the buzzer. I'm using the tone number 7. I'm giving the 300, then delay for 500. As I told you, you can refer to the Arduino software program, so we have explained all of them over there. Then delay for 500, and that's it. So it's compiling, everything is correct.